Baluchistan is often called the forgotten province of Pakistan because of its underdevelopment. The people of Baluchistan are resilient and amazing people. Today we'll be taking a look at 10 interesting facts about Baluchistan, Pakistan. What's going on, everybody? My name is Leroy Kenton, and for quite a while you guys have been requesting for us to do a video on Baluchistan. Now, before this video begins, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and for all of you new faces watching FTD Facts, hit that subscribe button and the bell notification because you don't want to miss any of our daily episodes. Okay, you ready for this? All right, let's begin. So, Baluchistan is one of the four provinces of Pakistan. It's the largest province in the country, covering 44% of the total area. The population sits at 12.34 million people, which is just 7% of the total population of the country of Pakistan. Most of the people living there are Baloch. Other communities include the Pashtuns and the Brahuis. The capital city of Baluchistan is Quetta, and it is located in the northeastern portion near Bolan Pass and the Sulaiman mountain ranges. This is the famous route that had been used by the British and other civilizations many years ago to invade Afghanistan. The traders of the other countries in the historic era entered the country by crossing the Bolan Pass and the Kandahar region. The province of Baluchistan is rich in natural resources like oil, gas, copper, and as well as gold, and the economy is dominated by its natural gas fields. Despite these huge deposits of mineral wealth, the area is one of the poorest regions in Pakistan. There's a large majority of its population that lives in deplorable housing conditions where they don't even have access to electricity or that much clean water to drink and use. Now, the location of the province is of extreme strategic importance as the province shares borders with Punjab, Sindh, as well as Afghanistan and Iran. Most importantly, the Gwadar port in Baluchistan is of immense importance to Pakistan. Now, if you're curious as what the name Baluchistan means, well, the name Baluchistan comes from the Baloch people, who are mostly Sunni Muslim people who speak the Iranian language Baluchi. Oddly, Baluchi has never been classified as an Eastern Iranian language like Pashto or Southwestern Iranian languages like Persian. Rather, Baluchi is a Northwestern Iranian language most closely related to Kurdish, and the word Baluchistan means the land of the Baloch. In ancient times, the region that is Baluchistan today was part of the Achaemenid Persian Empire, and then previous Persian and Indian empires and local kingdoms, and probably inhabited by some mix of Iranian as well as Indian people together. The region acquired a notorious reputation due to Alexander the Great disastrously marching back to Babylon after his Indian campaign through its deserts, and this led to the deaths of thousands of soldiers. Now, before the partition of India and Pakistan, Baluchistan was divided into four princely states, which were later acceded into Pakistan, even though the Baluchi people are ethnically, culturally, and socially different from the rest of Pakistan. And this often leads them to feel a bit exploited. The Baluchi people say that they're fairer than the fairest and darker than the darkest. Most of them settled in the south of Baluchistan and are dark-skinned, and history shows that they are descendants of African tribes. While those from western Baluchistan are fair in color and trace their lineage to Iranian and Arab tribes. And the final thing I want to share about Baluchistan is the Baluchi music. Now, it has a lot of energy in it. It's very different from the other kind of music that the people of Pakistan listen to. Women sing wedding songs for weeks upon weeks upon weeks, while the dance style called chop is done with a lot of clapping and other hand and foot movements. It makes Baluchistani weddings very fun. Now, Liwa, the African style of dancing, is performed in southern parts of Baluchistan, and watching it is like an experience on its own. So yeah, pretty fascinating stuff. So guys, that concludes this episode on Baluchistan. And now before I wrap everything up, just gotta let you know that this episode is brought to you by Grammarly.com. Grammarly is one of the world leading softwares that improve your written English skills. So the link is down below where you can install it for free. And as you're there typing, Grammarly is filled with a lot of spelling and grammatical errors that will help correct your English. So again, the link is down below where you can install it for free and enjoy. Guys, be sure to let me know down below what other FTD Facts episodes that you want to see. We do a lot of our videos by request, so it really, really helps when you leave comments like that down below. And that does it, guys. I'll see you real soon. Now, for everybody that made it to the end of this episode, here's a playlist of videos that I definitely highly recommend. You can learn a lot more about Pakistan as well as other cultures and places from different parts of the world. You guys have been awesome. Stay educated. And yeah, see you back here real soon in another video.